Hello everyone, welcome back. So in our last lecture, we discussed what is accounting, what is its definition, and we also read about the history of accounting, okay, from where the terms debit and credit came into picture. Now we realized that accounting covers four important things. First of all, that whatever is an economic event can be accounted for. So what is an economic event? We need to know that. Business organizations involve economic event. An economic event is known as a happening of consequence to a business organization, which consists of transactions and which are measurable in monetary terms. So for a general understanding, anything which has a financial impact can be measured in monetary terms is called an economic event. For example, purchase of machinery, installing and keeping it ready for manufacturing is an event which comprises number of financial transactions such as buying a machine, transportation of machine, site preparation for installation of a machine, expenditure incurred on its installation, trial runs. Thus, accounting identifies bunch of transactions relating to an economic event. If an event involves transactions between an outsider and an organization, these are known as external event. Who is an outsider? Any person who does not belong to the business, okay? He is not an employee, he is not the owner of the business. So the following are the examples of such transactions, like sale of merchandise to customers, rendering services to customers by ABC Limited, purchase of material from suppliers, payment of monthly rent to the landlord. All these people are external people, so these are external events. An internal event is an economic event that occurs entirely between the internal wings of an enterprise, like supply of raw materials or components by the store department to the manufacturing department, payment of wages to the employees. So whatever is happening internally of the organization is internal events. External to the organizations are external events. Now, first thing was economic event. Second thing in an accounting has to be identification, measurement, recording, and communication. So what do we understand by all these four? What is identification? It means determining what transaction to record, that is to identify events which are to be recorded. You cannot record all the transactions. Like in the last lecture, I told you, can you give a monetary number to your friendship with your best friend? No, we cannot. So it's not, we cannot identify for accounting purposes. That is to identify events which are to be recorded. It involves observing activities and selecting those events that are considered financial character and relate to the organization. The business transactions and other economic events, therefore, are evaluated for deciding whether it has to be recorded in the books of accounts. For example, the value of human resource, changes in managerial policies or appointment of personnel are important, but none of these are recorded in books of accounts. Why? Because these are qualitative things. These are not quantitative things. Now, however, when a company makes a sale or purchase, whether on cash or credit, or pays salary, it is recorded in the books of accounts. Because why? Money is either changing hands or will change hands in future. Measurement, second thing, it means quantification. I told you, qualitative thing we cannot record, we cannot measure it, but quantitative things we can put a number to it. So including estimates of business transactions into financial terms by using monetary unit rupees and paise as a measuring unit. If an event cannot be quantified into monetary terms, it is not considered for recording in financial accounts. That is why important items like the appointment of a new managing director, signing of contracts or changes in personnel are not shown in the books of accounts. Third thing is recording. So identifying only of financial and quantifiable things, then after identification, measurement, now after measurement, recording. Once the economic events are identified and measured in financial terms, these are recorded in books of accounts in monetary terms. and in a chronological order. What is chronological order? Chronological order means date wise. So whatever event is happening first will be recorded first, whatever happening at a later date will be recorded at the last. Okay. Recording is done in a manner that the necessary financial information is summarized as per well established practice and is made available as and when required. What is well established practice? That you cannot make accounting as per your whims and wishes. Okay, you cannot just devise your own accounting system. There is already an accounting system which you are here to study, and you have to learn that so that everyone does accounting the same way. If everyone does accounting the same way, the accounts of one company can be compared with accounts of other company. Okay. Last thing is communication. The economic events are identified, measured, recorded in the order that is pertinent information is generated and communicated in a certain form to management and other internal and external users. The information is regularly communicated through accounting reports. These reports provide information that are useful to a variety of users who have an interest in assessing the financial performance and other position of an enterprise, planning and controlling business activities, and making necessary decisions from time to time. The accounting information system should be designed in such a way that the right information is communicated to the right person at the right time. Reports can be daily, weekly, monthly, or quarterly, depending upon the needs of the user. An important element in the communication process is the accountant's ability and efficiency in presenting the relevant information. So, people, this communicating, we need account. Why do we need accounts? We need accounts so that we'll be able to make informed decisions. So, if I want to buy a land, I'll be really informed whether I have the capacity to buy the land or how much land I already have, how much more I need. Like these are communication. Next thing, after economic events, identification, measurement, recording, communication, the third thing was organization. What is organization? Organization refers to a business enterprise, whether for profit or not for profit motive. Depending upon the size of the activities and level of business operation, it can be a sole proprietary concern, partnership firm, cooperative society, company, local authority, municipal corporation, or any other association of persons. So accounting can be done for anyone, okay? Just that they need to have economic events. The last thing was interested user of information. Accounting is a means by which necessary financial information about business enterprises is communicated and is also called the language of business. So what is accounting? Accounting is also called language of business. Many users need financial information in order to make important decisions. These users can be divided into two broad categories, internal user and external users. Internal users include CEOs, CFOs, vice president, business unit manager, plant manager, store managers, line supervisor, etc. External users include present and potential investors, shareholders, creditors, bank and other financial institutions, debenture holders and other lenders, tax authorities, regulatory agencies, departments of company affairs, ROC, registrar of companies, Securities and Exchange Board of India, labor unions, trade associations, stock exchanges and customers, etc. Now all of you have to underline all these. Why? Because questions are generally asked. See, very few theory questions will be asked, and generally they'll be you can get a question like identify which are internal users and which are external users. So we need to find out like from here internal users and external users. And these examples only are generally asked in the exam. Yes. Since the primary function of accounting is to provide useful information for decision making, it is a means to an end, with the end being the decision that is held by the availability of accounting information. You will study about the types of accounting information and its users later in this chapter. So, in this video, we have discussed, in this chapter we have this lecture we have discussed economic events, identification, measurement, recording and communication, what is an organization and the users, okay, how accounting can be useful. So, last thing, why do the users want accounting information? We just studied. The owners, shareholders use them to see if they are getting satisfactory return on their investment and to assess the financial health of the company. That means if I invested in a company, I bought the shares of a company, I am the owner of the company, I want to know whether my investment is generating any money, any return for me or not. The directors or managers use them for making both internal and external comparisons in their attempts to evaluate the performance. They may compare the financial analysis of their company with the industry figures in order to ascertain the company's strength and weaknesses. Management is also concerned with ensuring that the money invested in the company or organization is generating an adequate return and the company or organization is able to pay its debt or remain solvent. So, internal users, okay, managers or MDs, they want accounting. Why? So that they can understand where they stand, what is the position of the company. Okay. Next, the creditors, lenders want to know if they are likely to get paid and look particularly at liquidity, which is the ability of the company or organization to pay its debt as they become due. So, the banks and all, they want to know your accounts. Why? So that they can find out whether you will be able to repay back the loan which you have taken or not. The prospective investors use them to assess whether or not to invest their money in the company or organization. So, whether to give you any more money or not depends upon your accounts. And the last, government and regulatory agencies such as Registrar of Companies, Custom Departments, IRDA, RBI, etc. require information for the payment of various taxes such as VAT, value-added tax, income tax, customs and excise duties for protecting the interest of investors. Now, there is no VAT or excise duties because GST has come and taken its place. Okay. For creditors, lenders and also to satisfy the legal obligations imposed by Companies Act 2013 and SEBI from time to time. Still, theory is not over because in this chapter we will be doing more of theory, but this topic is done. I hope you have understood why accounting is needed. Okay, we will see you in the next lecture. Thank you.